What is up, gang?
You won.
Oh, you are just now finding out about me going. You just now find out about that.
I just now find out. You're barely just finding out about this now?
You barely just find out about it.
You just barely found out. I'm pulling a Brandon. I sleep in hotel room.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Brandon and King's GM Extravaganza, where we have our first pay-per-view, and that's going to be the title of the episode, too. So now it's not going to be all SmackDown stuff. No. We have this and this only. I don't even have promos. But first,
let me take a selfie.
I was doing a dance. I gotta re-sign a couple people.
Re-sign, rebuild, reclaim. Muhammad?
I gotta keep their rivalry going. Bye bye, Lita and Tori Wilson. I'll re-sign you when I make a new rivalry. But for now, I'm good. Okay, so let me get through this this pretty quick, cause I still got to book Raw, and then he's got to book SmackDown, so it's gonna be a little bit longer than usual. And you know what? You know what we gotta do?
What?
These are specialty match types right here. Look at this: a Hell in a Cell match, Triple H's Undertaker. I'm doing this 4 years before it happens. Actually, 5 years before it happens.
No, that happened at 2012.
Was it?
Yeah.
Damn.
Because that was twice in a lifetime.
Yeah, I guess Shawn Michaels is 22. 26. WrestleMania 26. Okay. Yeah, alright, yeah. I was trying to remember what my feuds were for a second. So John Cena's a little tired right now, so I'm just going to do a regular single match for this. John Cena, Kane. Intercontinental title on the line, of course. It's a pay-per-view. And now this one... No, you know what? I'll leave that blank for right now. Let me go to my first match here. This is going to be No, that'd be too goofy.
Wouldn't it be funny if I did a how many words can you type in a minute test with my keyboard during the recording?
That would not be funny.
Okay. I'm going to stream that tomorrow.
We're going to get Muhammad Hassan and Ric Flair in a hardcore match.
Like he was saying, he wouldn't watch if I streamed Chicken Little, a game.
Get fucked! Oh, that's kind of hilarious, though. What the hell?
And I kind of don't want to play it because the Steam version doesn't have controller support.
Mikey, would you watch if I played... if I played Chicken Little on stream? No. No, I would not watch Brent. I'd watch. You get a 30-minute Iron Man match. No. What am I doing? I had the idea in my head the whole time. Special referee. Single.
Bo Burnham.
Stacy Keebler. And Trish Stratus. With special referee. Tori Wilson. Women's title on the line.
Don't put a woman on the pay-per-view.
We got too much
Don't
left.
Put the woman on the pay-per-view. This is so easy to book a pay-per-view. I really got to make a big poo.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
Ha 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 ha. He he.
And now Randy Orton's fed up with Eugene's shit, so he said, steel cage match, Eugene.
Is Google Stadia just Parsec?
I hope. Okay, now we got a big PP on the line.
Fulfill your fantasy.
Okay. Oh, I should have done a fulfill your fantasy match. Why can't I do?
It's a women only match.
Yeah, but it's not like I don't have anybody in the match.
No.
So it doesn't make any sense.
It's not allowed for pay-per-view.
It's like, all right, we can't be having that for pay-per-view. I want to do a specialty match for all of them because it's a pay-per-view.
Doug Basham. Is this Extreme Rules?
Nope.
Well, Backlash was Extreme Rules eventually.
Yeah. Let's do a solid table.
A solid table? A New Japan table? Only real wrestling fans will understand that one.
And then Carl Toe. I think that's all the wrestlers I got, yep.
Carlito.
Alright, Carl Toe.
My toe.
An expensive card, but worth it.
But it's pay-per-view. Yeah. You gotta go all out.
And I would make this a special match, but John Cena is like 40% fatigued right now, so he's going to get a singles match. Because I think I had him in a backstage brawl or something last week.
Let the boy rest.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. For all of the marbles in their feud, maybe not, I don't know. Ric Flair wins the hardcore match. He's the dirtiest player in the game. He used all the tricks and foreign objects to his advantage.
Ric Flair's the hardcore champion.
Oh, and with help from Torrie Wilson, Trish Stratus retains.
Those T's.
Oh!
Yeah!
Yes! I like how the game books Eugene just like he was booked in real life. So Randy Orton is livid right now.
He's going to that place.
Okay, they retain.
Come on, new camp. Kane.
Yes.
Kane!
Yes. Yes, that's what I wanted.
Okay. Come on, Undertaker.
Oh!
I'm the Houdini of Backlash 2012.
I did not want that, though. I was going to put John Cena against Triple H and Kane versus Undertaker for the Intercontinental title.
Imagine Kane versus Undertaker for an IC title.
But I might have to make Triple H go down to the WWE or the Intercontinental title and Kane go up to the... No, because he's Intercontinental champion. Oh, we're all fucked. I do this every time.
You gotta make Triple H. Okay.
See the fan change. Oh, big boy bucks. Jesus.
No fair, you're gonna pay. Holy shit.
Don't worry though, you'll get a pay-per-view. New champ, okay. Results. New deal for Ric Flair. New champs. Tag team title defended. Kane won. Okay. I wanna look at the reports.
JR, go to JR. Look at that main event. Holy shit. Fucking 4.5 stars.
This was a better match than the women's match. It's finally, their feud's gotten so hot that it's actually better. What a match between Randy Orton and Eugene. Way better than this.
You think he did a Canadian Destroyer?
Which one?
Eugene's got him on the Canadian Destroyer.
All right. Yes, that's what I.
That's
want
what he. That's what Eugene says when he hits.
Oh my!
Yo, what the fuck?
Those are gonna be some big balls. Okay, right, JR report. Let's just book another. Wait, no. Let me look at my rivalries. See how good we're doing.
Last week on Raw.
After 4 weeks, Ric Flair and Muhammad Hassan still going hot. I guess I'll keep it going then.
Fucking Ric Flair's a racist.
I need some money.
I need a Jew. Family Guy song. Family Guy. What are they feeding you?
No, that's not what I want to look at the T. Oh, Cena's hurting. the song.
Thank you, mama, man.
I can't hear it because I would be hearing myself.
Okay, well, Cena doesn't need to be in a match, so I gotta work around that. So, I'm just gonna have a bad Raw this week. I just got a bunch of fans. I think I'm good. Singles.
Do you think that's what they do in real wrestling? They're like, we got a bunch of fans. Let's just have a bad Raw. But they do that every week.
Okay, that's what I want. Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Meat on the table, yeah, that's what you are. Yeah, you can run, but you don't get to kill.
And it's going to be for the title. Let's see if let's see what happens.
Dude, what would happen?
That way I still keep both of them involved. Both of those rivalries stay the same. And if they don't, oh well, I'm going to make a new rivalry.
I'd be so mad if I paid for a pay-per-view just to see a title match and they have the same title match and next night on Raw.
It's not the same title match. One was a Hell in a Cell and then one was a... And then this one's with two fucking people as same their managers. Wrestlers. Not same wrestlers. There's two more people.
Know what I'm saying.
Okay, you know what? You know what?
You don't know what I'm saying.
Boom, I kind of wanted to do this anyway, so... Oh, fucking... How about that, huh?
Yeah.
And then now... For this... Wait, give me a second. I gotta look at my rivalry again. Because I know. Okay, it's JBL and Eddie Guerrero. It's in a rivalry.
JB Layfield.
For some reason, Rey Mysterio and Carlito aren't, but JB Layfield and GGG.
JB Layfield. What are you on? GGG.
Randall Keith. Eugene. Randy, this is your last chance.
I'd rather eat grunge.
Randy's like, I want a rematch. I want a rematch.
Right fucking now.
Okay. Yeah. Damn it. What's wrong with me?
You got a big peenie.
Thank you.
I'm gonna go weenie.
What is Rey? What is Rey Mysterio? Is he on the... Yeah, he's on the fucking other side.
Booyacker.
This is how you do it right here, Brandon. You ready? You ready? Boop.
Hi-ya-ho. Hi-ya-ho. Hi-ya-ho.
This is how you do it, Brandon. I'm telling you.
Whoa. You just copied me when I had a manager.
They got all the fucking people.
They got all the people. I got toast and jam.
This really pisses me off. You see this? I want it to be flipped. So now I'm going to have to be like, yeah. Yeah. Just so I can go. Yeah. Watch them get, like, fatigued by being, managers.
Why the fuck does Sebi follow the amusement park I work at on Instagram? He's on something else. I'm calling you out right now, Sebi.
You know what? It's their last, it's their last hurrah here.
Hurrah?
Haram.
Haram Hussein.
It's the last hurrah of Lita and Tori Wilson, so just have a fatal four-way.
The last non-title, of course. Last week on Raw.
And then, you know, old reliable.
Oh my god. Now yeah. I know why they have me for 9 hours that day, Kang. I'm just going to talk about my work on this episode. I don't care. The world's largest swimming lesson. At the section I work at.
There we go.
I'm going to, there's going to be so much dirt. Oh, baby. Friday night okay. SmackDown. Let me
Brandon,
just see.
If you don't beat me this week, I'm
know. Just bad at the
game. Yeah.
Okay, let's go. It's been a bit. I'm going to break the fourth wall. Rob Van Dam versus Paul Lundan. Kurt Angle versus Doug Basham. Christian versus Chris Jericho versus Ed.
Edge's fucking smile gets me every time.
It looks like a mustache. Wait.
I gotta like screenshot that and send a picture to
How did
him
Christian
on Twitter?
Versus Big Show become a rivalry? What's with Christian?
He looks That's angry. Not... He's pointing at me.
Shawn Michaels and Batista. Okay.
Kurt Angle looks like a fucking thumb.
I almost went 3 months in advance. Okay, let's go to the moon. Pulse. We're gonna have a tag team main event.
Whoa.
Elimination tag.
Calm down, Gato.
Yo, fuck you. Who's that be? And it's gonna be normal tag. And we're gonna change superstars. And the first team, we're gonna have Doug Basham. And who's someone who's not doing anything? Who's a good guy? Danny. Doug Basham. Fuck.
Booker
I booked myself and Chris Benoit.
I don't think Booker T was doing anything.
Versus Kurt Angle.
Chris Benoit has got a rivalry.
And Danny Basham. And actually Booker T because I said so.
Okay.
Okay. Got that. Now let's get a cool promo in. Let's build hype for the main event.
That was really weird. I didn't have any
I'm gonna do another
sound.
Promo.
It was just a
advertisement promo. And we're gonna go back. Why is my SmackDown so long?
It's the same length as mine. You got six rivalries, you got six matches.
Rob Van Dam, Chris Jericho Edge.
Oh, Booker T and
Booker
Chris
T is in a rivalry.
I knew Chris Benoit was, but I didn't know Booker T was, and they're in a rivalry
Whatever.
Against each other. So either way, you would have fucked up that rivalry.
Christian versus Big Show in the opening match.
I mean, I don't think you need five or six rivalries on your show. You don't need that.
I fuck that you every
can't do
time.
But six singles matches.
I fuck this every time. Yo, how did it do? Look what it auto went to. What the fuck?
Heel turn from Doug Basham. Former
he
world champ.
So sick. Big Show. Christian. Chris Jericho. Bada bam. Coolest match in the ring. Match two. We're gonna have a title match. And it's, ooh, one person's already there. Ooh, Robert Van Dam
and Paul London,
and we're gonna make it. What's a cool match? Ladder.
Now you gotta do it all over again.
How did that?
You know, You know how that works. You just change the whole match. There is no just change participants in this version, alright? You're not playing universe mode.
I sent him into universe mode.
Better make it a title match.
Ooh. You right.
You're lucky I'm helping you with these.
Yo, fuck.
I think you just made it a non-title match. Okay, no. No, you did. You fucking hit it like 7 times. Okay, you don't have a match 5, you don't have a match 4, or a match 3.
Okay. See my current champion. Look how cool this champion. Okay. What else we got? Shawn Michaels versus Batista.
We're actually getting pretty good on time, Brandon. If you can finish it in like the next 2 to 3 minutes, I think we'll be still under that 30-minute mark. We're usually around 25 minutes.
Shawn Michaels, Batista, go!
That's one of your rivalries. So you're continuing that.
My other rivalries, I'll already put them in other matches. Okay, I'll just put Edge versus some random guy and then go. Some random match.
Well, didn't you you had a tag team of like the Big Show and Orlando Jordan or something, and they were facing Christian and.
That's why Big Show's fighting them.
Chris Jericho.
But alone.
Yeah, kind of like mine's Eddie Guerrero versus JBL for no reason. So why don't you just do what I did?
No. Edge versus Shelton Benjamin. Good match.
Solid.
One more match. This will just be an exhibition match. We want to have Orlando
versus the one person available.
Fuck, who is he? Batista? No.
Chris Benoit. The only guy that's white versus the only guy that's black. Nah, he's
in the world.
You got Booker T.
Yes.
Okay.
Can I simulate? Or you go to simulate yours first?
Go to mine first.
Yeah. Muhammad.
Okay, let's see if Ric Flair wins this one as well. He does. Oh, I don't know if this rivalry can sustain if Ric Flair is just winning all the time.
Ric Flair drip in his hometown of Concord, New Hampshire.
Oh, and Lita wins the Fatal 4-Way on her last night in the company.
Ooh.
Oh, Carlito beats Rey Mysterio 1-on-1. Now, can Eddie beat JBL? Or will the tag team of... Caribbean businessmen take the cake. Nah, Eddie beats JB Layfield, so it's a wash on what the better tag team is. We just know that Ray will lose against Carlito.
Ray Romano.
Oh,
Eugene!
Randy Orton can't beat Eugene.
He's got his fucking number.
Oh, and Taker retains against his brother.
Yes,
Kane the Undertaker beats Kane...
With John Cena.
Okay.
Lego.
Ooh. Oh, with the help of Chris Jericho.
Rob Van Dam retains. Shawn Michaels beats the Batista. Shelton, fuck, I wanted Edge to be such a big star. And you just get to see them getting fucked.
Oh.
Orlando Jordan beat Chris Benoit, a true hero. And Doug Basham and Booker T and Kurt Angle and Danny Basham. That's gotta mean they're in the title hunt. Ooh! Match of the week.
Oh, I still win? Yo, you're such a bum!
That's so stupid. How is my gonna be worse?
I had such a shit show and I still beat you by 20,000 fans.
We had the same rating!
Yeah, but mine's just a little bit better.
Fuck me. This match has to go to the Shawn Michaels match. It was a share of momentum swings, and they ended with a great finish. The match definitely was a standout match for SmackDown this past week. The fans agreed as it landed the highest rated match. It will be in the DVD.
The champion was able to pull out the match and retain the title this past week. Undertaker defended the WWE Championship in an exciting match. The Raw Superstar seems to have long-term plans for the belt. Will there be a re-dash match? How long will the champ be able to sustain this winning streak?
Winning streak, Undertaker.
When it rains, it pours. Stacy Keibler couldn't pull out a victory, even if the opponent was flat on their back in the sleep of the ring. Jesus! This last
Why
week
are they
marked
so
the fifth
there?
Loss in a row. The superstar will have to rethink their strategy and start a new training program or find a friend to lend a hand in the next match. I actually know she's gone.
In case you missed the great match earlier this week, WWE superstar Booker T was able to pull out a victory in a tag team match. The match between these high-profile superstars was highly anticipated by the fans. Even some of the superstars in the locker room were seen intently waiting on the outcome of the match.
Eugene was victorious this past week. There are a lot of factors influencing how long the superstar will be able to keep winning matches, keeping a high morale, training hard, recovering properly, and maintaining a drive for greatness are all key factors in the longevity of the superstar's career.
The article below, it says, a victory for Eddie Guerrero, .. like something's about to go wrong.
they knew. There are quite a few superstars that... we've fucking seen this one like 7 times. Eddie won.
His ratings.
Let's look at the fan support first.
Hey, mine's closing in.
No, it's not.
Yes.
Okay, let's look at Raw results. Okay, solid 2.5-star match. Solid 2-star. Ew. 2.5, 2.5. 3-star match. And then a 3.5-star match.
Go to me. Go to Meep. Oh, that's me. Wait a second. Oh.
You had a worse one than me. Don't worry. It was worse. Actually, it was... I would say enough to where that's a 2-star compared to mine being a 2.5-star.
Fuck. If this match had another 0.5-star, which it should have... Fuck me. Okay. Doug Basham won, at least.
Hey, at least that was your, tied for highest rated. Okay. Well.
How was that the match of the week? When you had a match with more stars?
I don't know.
No, go to you. Yeah, you have a match with more stars, and my match is the match of the week.
I don't know. Maybe,
Maybe you landed too much on your neck in that match and people didn't like it as much.
Well, we're done with this episode. After a pay-per-view, a Raw, and a SmackDown, you got enough bang for your buck to blow your load. So,
see you next week. But after Kang does his plugs.
After I plug the Liu Kang cast, which you can watch every Wednesday morning. And then also later in the night on that same very Wednesday every single week, Wednesday night Smack Talk. I would hope you know that it's on a Wednesday, considering it's in the name. Also, we have The Wolf Among Us, which is just about to end, so go binge watch that and catch the last episode, or the second to last episode, I'm not sure fully, as it comes out. Or if you're watching this at a later date and you're binging on this, go binge that.
Binge on these nuts.
And also... SmackDown Saturday, if you can guess when that comes out, I think it's Saturday. Yeah, that's where I play through SmackDown Shut Your Mouth as the Bidneth Man in season mode. So, go watch that. Another wrestling video game. If you like this, I'm sure you'll like that. That one's got more gameplay than this one, if you want more action. So now, I say, Brandon... Yeah, you have a YouTube channel. Go subscribe to Brandon.
I do got a YouTube channel. I'm going to stream Chicken Little 2 soon. No, Chicken Little soon. There's no Chicken Little 2.
And go follow both of us on Twitter. Links will be in the description for his channel and his Twitter and my Twitch, which I am live streaming on right now as we're recording this. So if you want to see SmackDown vs. Raw 2006 GM mode with Brandon and Kang, GM extravaganza mode with Brandon and Kang a little bit early, then you can. So do that. Go on my Twitch. I got VODs up and I live stream too. So yeah. Now I think I've plugged just about everything I can.
Wait.
So,
come to the amusement park I work at.
Yeah, come to go to.
Don't say the name. I don't want to say.
Go to Brandon's workplace.
Canada's Wonderland.
Yeah, go there.
Get at me.
I think that's about it. So
come to Splashworks.
What do we say to the nice men, Brandon?
Thank you for the candy.
I'm back. THANKYOU. Thank you. Thank you. THANKYOU. Thank you, Kang.